Good evening to one and all present here. I'm Shruti Govindarajan, first year MDA student from the Department of Oral Pathology and Microbiology. My topic for today's presentation is DNA profiling, the fast track course of forensic investigations. Yes, it is a toast to all forensic specialists as you solve a puzzle from details the others don't generally know. The keywords I've used here are DNA profiling, rape, dental DNA, molecular forensic sciences, victim identification. In India, there has been a drastic increase in rape and murder cases and subsequent increase in tampering of that evidence. Therefore, in 2005, the Code of Criminal Procedure, CRPC, revised the Section 53A. As you can see under the point 2, where I violated the fourth statement, where they mentioned that it is permissible to take sample for evidence from both accused and the victim at the time or after the crime scene for DNA profiling. Such is the importance of DNA profiling. In India, dental forensics has led to breakthroughs in solving many impactful cases in history, such as the Sheena Bora case, assassination of former PM Mr. Rajiv Gandhi, assassination of Jaichand Raja of Kannauj. But cases like Nirbhaya rape case, Hathras, Unnao rape case, Hyderabad rape case, where the victim was not only raped, but murdered and mutilated or burned, where not only crime was committed, but the tampering with evidence was profound and it turned out to be dreadful. What happens in such scenarios? What happens if most commonly available evidence is made extinct? This is where DNA profiling or fingerprinting comes to rescue. Now, what is DNA profiling? It is a process of determining an individual's characteristics. Variations in DNA sequencing called polymorphisms can be used both to differentiate and to correlate individuals. What is the process of DNA fingerprinting? DNA fingerprinting, it begins with the process of collection of sample for evidence from the site, victim, and the accused. From the sample, the DNA in the cell is exposed by breaking down the cell membrane and its integrity. Then this exposes the DNA and the fragments are broken down with help of restriction enzymes and it is subjected to electrophoresis. The DNA pattern is transferred to a nylon membrane or an radioactive probe is used which binds to a specific DNA. A unique DNA pattern is obtained which is transferred to X-ray film. On direct exposure and its development, DNA fingerprints is obtained. The samples obtained for DNA profiling is then matched with the other associated reference samples for matching and confirmation. A number of cases where the human remains were beyond visual recognition and also for retrieving data about the perpetrator, DNA profiling came to the rescue. However, dental DNA profiling seems to be more beneficial in even more compromised situations. Dental DNA profiling is not a very commonly used method in India, but physical evidence cannot be intimidated. It does not forget it. It sits there and needs to be detected, preserved, evaluated, and explained. Such an intact and solid evidence can be obtained from dental DNA as a layer of dentin and enamel armors around the pulp, when subjected to extreme situations or environmental factors, nothing happens, nothing or any minimal, only minimum changes occur to the pulp, not much is seen. The extreme factors are heat, cold, putrefaction, trauma, mutilation, etc. What is DNA? The dental DNA is most often taken from the pulp of mostly the posterior tooth because of its high pulpal volume. Then the same process of DNA fragmentation, pattern transfer, DNA probing, and radiography will be done to retrieve DNA fingerprints. The different methods that can be applied to dental DNA are hybridization-based methods, PCR-based methods, sequence-based technology, reverse dot blow assays, and microchip assays. What are the benefits of dental DNA extraction? As said before, the dental pulp or the dental DNA, they can survive extreme environmental conditions like heat, putrefaction, cold, trauma, mutilation, etc. They are easier to access. Genomic DNA and also ancestral, the ADNA, and also the mitochondrial DNA can be obtained. Accuracy when compared with that of the DNA obtained from blood or any other sample from the human body was found to be similar. As per records, the accuracy from the dental DNA was found to be 82.7%. It is cost effective, quicker results can be retrieved, and also gender typing with help of amelogenin can be done. Therefore, as once the former president of the United States, Mr. Barack Obama, said, we know we can't stop every act of violence, every act of evil in the world, but maybe we could try to stop one act of evil, one act of violence. But when a case has already reached the forensic specialist, it means the crime has already been committed, and for every crime, there has to be a punishment. And I think that punishment can be delivered with certain justice with the help of forensic sciences. And therefore, we should say a yes more often to dental DNA profiling. Thank you so much. And these are my references.